Welcome to a very special pre-recorded session of Tor US's Touring Masters Lobby B. Once again, this is Zeta 085 in the comms booth, and with him today is Big Ben, who's providing the replay footage. How are you doing tonight?
I am doing good. It's nearing midnight my time, but I'm pretty good. I'm pumped up. I'm ready to commentate, man.
All right. Let's just get this thing set up. All right. Are you ready to begin?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Counting down in 3, 2, 1, play. All right. As soon as the grid lines up, we're gonna start where everyone is. In this case, through turn three. Now, since you've already raced, you can provide some details here and there in case I miss something.
All right. I'll be able to tell you on some other places to look.
All right, without further ado, we're going to do the starting grid. Find the arrow. Starting with row one on the pole, way up in front, Big
Sorry.
Ben. Next to him, coming up soon, Min Charger. In row two, we have EZT Cool. And next to him, Mr. Shannon to you. In row three, we have Yellowy Chief. And next to him will be Iceman X41. In seventh, for row four, we have Who is John Galt 87. And next to him will be Camshaft 360. In row five, we have Tyrannic Symbols. And in last place, finally, the only R32 in the event, Midnight Rider. All right, folks, that concludes your starting grid here today at Road America. Okay, so we have a bit of time before the pack makes their way up to turn 14. Is there anything in particular you'd like to provide feedback-wise for everyone here in Lobby B?
It was really good racing all night. There were some scrapes, there were a couple of bumps here and there, but predominantly everyone was cool about what was going on. There was no outright complaints about anything. There was good-natured what's the word I want to use? Rib poking and just general trolling all night long. So it was a really good lobby to be in, and it was, despite the fact that it got really spread out towards the end, it was still good racing all night long.
Unfortunately, I'm sure Twitch chat has died down since Lobby A is concluded. But do not fret, you'll be seeing Lobby B. Now, what was the reason why you and the lobster picked the Starion?
Well, we picked Starion. I kind of touched on this earlier. We picked the Starion because no one had signed up for it. I mean, no one had. And we were able to get quite a bit of power and quite a bit of torque out of the thing and still keep it really low on the weight spectrum. I don't remember exactly how much it weighed, but it was around the range of 2,600 pounds. We also were able to keep some actual width in the rear tires. Now, as you can see, I'm trying to warm up here.
Yes, we just saw you go off of turn 14 for a little
I'm a
bit.
little ahead of you now. There, that might help.
Okay. And for those who are just wanted to point out real quick, Windcharger has two purple rectangles on the back of his bumper. This is not to indicate that he's a rookie. This is to indicate that he's part of the media team. He's only going to be participating in Road America and Road Atlanta. He'll be back in the comms booth next week. And as the starting procedure is here at Tora, there has to be a distance of 25 feet between each driver. And
It's
usually this
kind of,
does take some time.
yeah, it's really difficult to do on tracks like Road America where there aren't nice little starter boxes. You just kind of have to look up and try to figure out, okay, nudge it over a foot, back it up a little bit more. It's kind of like doing the robot, you're just kind of just backwards and forwards until you get it right.
Now, unfortunately for Lobby, it took about, I'd say, a minute or so for when it got set up. It wasn't too bad, I take it, for you guys.
Yeah. Let me check real quick. Yep, we're all lined up, and we're going to go right now.
All right, folks, the green flag is out for the first round of Lobby B here at Road America. And Big Ben gets the lead, followed by Wind Charger and a three-way in the middle of the pack.
Yeah, we were really close to either come to this first corner. Not nearly as close as we're going through it the second race, but we were very close together.
Alright, we see Big Ben has gained the lead with Wind Charger in second, followed by Mr. Shannon Tiu in third. Alright, we see the top three starting to pull away from the rest of the pack here, going down the first long straightaway.
Going back through the pack, you can see that, I can never remember his name or tag.
Some contact here between Wind Charger and Big Ben going through the boring straight. And it looks like Mr. Shan Tiu is going to get the second spot from Wind Charger. And he's going to be working up on first place.
Yeah, Wind Charger and I just kind of didn't quite read each other right. I could see him coming, so I was able to get my car a little bit off to the left, so we only hit part of my car. So I didn't take actually any damage from that. At least it didn't show up.
All right, we're right now on the rear bumper cam as Mr. Shannon Tiu blocks Wind Charger pretty hard going through the hurry downs. Making their way through the American Carousel, Wind Charger's going to bite back. He has him on the inside, Shannon on the outside, and Yellowy Chief is now caught up in the mix. Ooh, those two are really going at it.
Yeah, they're going to be going at it for a couple of minutes here. So you might want to keep a close eye on them.
Wind Charger goes wide with Shannon in tow. Yellowy Chief is now caught up to Shannon. Oh, and some contact between Yellowy Chief and Iceman. Whether it was intentional or not is hard to say.
Yeah, like I said, it was a very courteous group of guys. There were the sorry, yeah, it's racing, it's okay. And it was just very courteous to each other.
And it looked like Easy TQ got into the rear bumper there. Alright, folks, we've completed our first actual lap here at Road America. Because the warm-up lap does not count. We are right now focusing on Tyrannic Symbols, who is now catching up to Easy Tikkut. Speaking of, we're going to go on board with him right now. And as I say that, Coot is starting to pull away.
I've raced with Coot a couple of times here and there, and he is a really quick driver when it comes to ovals. He and all the EZT guys are really good at doing
and
ovals.
And Tyrannic Symbols has just cut right in front of him. This is going to put... that was Camshaft, actually. So Camshaft has now moved into 7th. Actually, he just might lose it. Here comes Tyrannic Symbols. Unfortunately, Midnight Rider's not faring too well in the back. The only R32 here.
Yeah, Wind Charger, I'm looking at Wind Charger. Midnight Rider seems to have an off night. I've raced with him before, and I know he's a pretty quick guy, so I don't know if his tune for the R34 didn't quite agree with Road America, or even just having an off night, but kudos to him for keeping in it and making sure that when he had the opportunity, he got past people.
Alright, just moving up to the field real quick. Unfortunately, Yellowy Chief has just destroyed his clutch.
That might be a little bit of a laggy replay there, though.
Well, if that's the case, then it should fix itself out momentarily.
Yeah.
Speaking of, Yellowy Chief has now caught up to Shannon.
Yeah, those Volvo 24... I believe Shannon's in the 242, isn't he?
Yes.
Okay, those 242s, both hims and... Both his and who is John... That John they were Gaunt. Both John Gaunt. Sorry, I'm just gonna call him John. Him and his and John's Volvos were really pulling up this front straight really hard.
And it looks like Iceman will be slowly catching up to Yellowy Chief in just a minute here, exiting turn three. Looks like Windcharger is starting to catch up to you a little bit here.
Let's see, where am I? Which rep? Oh, okay. Yeah, I was not paying fully attention for some reason, so I was shifting down at places I didn't really need to, so I was actually slowing myself down in the process.
Alright, looks like Yellowy Chief is starting to close the gap even more on Shannon. And it looks like we have a battle with Tyrannic Symbols in the back. It's now caught up to Camshaft 360.
And John is just right there, just waiting for them, one of them to make a mistake.
Well, John Galt is going to be drafting off Tyrannic Symbols going through the American Carousel. Oh, and there goes Tyrannic Symbols and John Galt. Looks like Monkey See, Monkey Do.
Yep.
And Jungle goes wide again over the rumble strip exit, going right through that turn.
Oh, meanwhile, up in there's a huge battle for sixth and fifth with Coop trying to get it moved down on get on Shannon, but unfortunately Shannon gets the cut back and is able to get back around Coop and just start pulling away a little bit.
And it looks like he lost the position to Iceman and Yellowy Chief.
Yeah, let me check to see.
I'm perfect.
No, you're right. I don't remember what happened.
But we're now down to three more laps here at Road America. Yellowy Chief has now moved into third place, followed by Iceman in fourth. Just going to focus on these two for a little bit. Yeah, you're right. Definitely a lot of position swaps going on throughout the entire pack.
Mm-hmm.
Passing through the moraine straight, going through turn 5. Iceman is trying to keep up with the Yellowy Chief.
I went back and looked. Shannon went a little bit wide on... which turn is that? The turn right before the carousel.
Well, they're going through hurry downs, and Yellowy Chief just went sideways for a moment. It's going to allow Iceman to catch up to him.
Anyway, the point is, Shannon went wide on one turn. That's how both Yellowy Chief and Iceman were able to get past him.
Alright, both drivers are now halfway through the American Carousel. Yellowy Chief hugging the rumble strip. However, Iceman had enough of an exit to catch right up to him. coming through Canada Corner, we see Yellowy Chief going onto the safety area. As Shannon is starting to lose some ground to both him, losing both to Yellowy Chief and Iceman. Alright, we're now going to be at 2 laps to go momentarily. And it looks like Iceman is caught right up into the rear of Yellowy Chief. They're going to be side by side soon coming down the back straightaway. Yellowy Chief on the outside. Iceman is going to dive right back in. Coming on the front straightaway, about to enter turn one, Yellowy Chief is going to hold his line. However, Iceman is going to have him on the inside. However, he slowed down. This is going to give Yellowy Chief his current position still.
Meanwhile, while this is going on, I cannot talk anymore. Wind Treasure and I have just started to slowly pull away from the pack and just kind of run off on our own.
And Shannon has now caught up to Iceman. So now it's 3rd, 4th, and 5th place, with 2 laps to go. However, Iceman has slowed down considerably.
Ooh, back in 9th place. John took the one corner a little bit too wide. He oversteered through it, and it actually ended up clipping the wall back before Corvette Bridge.
Unfortunately, Iceman is starting to make some mistakes here, coming right through Canada, the American Carousel. However, Shannon is also starting to fall behind a little bit. The gap between 3rd, 4th, and 5th is starting to spread out a little too thin for my taste.
It's not every day you see two Playboy sponsored cars going at it.
Well, if we count Mugello, that was almost an incident.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Unfortunately, I missed that race because I was finishing up in a different series.
No, that's okay. You can just watch the video on Tor's YouTube channel.
I might have to.
You should. It was by far the best racing I've seen to date. All right, folks. White flag is out. 1 lap to go. Big Ben still leads, with Windcharger in second, followed by Yellowy Chief, Iceman, Shannon, Easy T Coot, Tyrannic Symbols, Camshaft 360, Who's John Gold, and Midnight Rider. Alright, folks, it looks like Iceman and Shannon are going to be going at it. Iceman goes wide through turn one, off the track, and this is going to give Shannon fourth place. Unfortunate news for Iceman, going through the Moraine Strait, exiting turn 5. He took it too late, and this is now widening the gap between him and Shannon. It's also nice to see the Jägermeister back once again for this season, as it was in the original Touring Masters by, it was Flying Mikey J. And it looks like Midnight Rider took the turn passing Hurry Downs a little too wide, and he's also taken some front arrow damage. Not looking good for the R32. Alright, checker flag is in the air. Big Ben has just exited turn 14, is now going up the back straightaway. With no one around, our winner goes to Big Ben.
Yeah, I was pretty excited at this point because I have, like I said earlier, I have not really done any forts or any tour events, so this is actually my first win at a tour event.
And Windcharger gets second place. Congratulations, fellow media teammate. In third will be Yellowy Chief. Fourth, coming up the back straightaway past our finish line, is Mr. Shannon to you. Fifth will go to Iceman. Followed by EZT Coot. Tyrannic Symbols in seventh. Oh, very close contact between Tyrannic Symbols and Camshaft. However, it's going to go to Tyrannic Symbols. Nice recovery. Camshaft is going to get eighth, followed by John Galt and Midnight Rider. Good thing we caught that. All right, folks, we'll be right back for round two.